What is up, everyone? Welcome back to my Learning C++ tutorial series, and today we're going to be learning about input. Again, my name is Joe, or Hoodie Mage, as I'm known here on YouTube, and like I said, we're going to be learning about input today, a brief introduction to it, and so we've dealt with output so far using the cout command, and today we're going to be using a different command. So let's go ahead and create a new project. And again, Win32 console application. This is going to be example 2.3. Again, if you want, you can, instead of creating a new project for each one of these examples, you can just create a new source file and just have like section one solution and just have a bunch of source files in there, because when you make a project file, it does take up with, like, for example, one source document, like one C++ file in it. It's going to take up about 10 megabytes, so if you're, you know, concerned about taking up too much space on your hard drive, just use one project. But since I have tons and tons of space available to me, I'm going to go crazy and create a new project for each example that I do. So again, make sure it's an empty project. We'll go ahead and create that. And we're going to add our source file. And this source file for today is, again, make sure it's a C++ source file. And we're going to call this one getInfo. And we'll add that in here. And hopefully, yep, looks like my changes have remained. So again, we're going to be dealing with some input in this example, so I'm going to go ahead and type up the code here. So it's our getInfo, C++, input and output. So we'll be using output again, but we've gone over that quite extensively already, so we don't need to talk about it super in depth. So we're going to use our namespace std and include our IOStream so we can actually use these input and output commands. We're going to define a variable that is an integer called carats, and we're going to see out how many carats do you have, and we're going to put a line there. Then we have a new command, cin, and we'll explain that in a second here. Then we're going to output some more stuff. Here are two more. And then we're going to modify the value of carats so that carats is carats plus 2. And we're going to add a little comment here. And output one more line. And we're gonna return, but first, to make sure we can actually see our beautiful program running, we're gonna pause to get an enter key from the user before we go on to return 0. Okay. So this one's going to be pretty quick, since we really only have one line here that we need to explain in any sort of detail. And real quick, before I forget, let me add a little comment in here. Since we're talking about input, you can imagine that this new command has to do with input, and you're right. Ah, gosh, you're so smart, you're catching on quick. Okay, so let's go over the program real quick. We're including our IOStream header file so that we can use our input and output commands. Again, they are actually objects, but since we haven't talked about objects yet, I'm going to be calling them commands for now. The book at this point actually does kind of go into a little bit of what objects are and why cout and cin are objects, but I'm going to leave that for later, just because I think it's not really important to understand that concept at this point. We will definitely get to objects in great, great, great detail later on. Quite a bit later. Anyway, so we have our using namespace std, so we can just type cout instead of, as you can see here on our little tooltip, if it's displaying on YouTube, sometimes it doesn't record. Instead of typing in the std colon colon cout. Then we are declaring a variable called carrots and telling it that it's going to be of the data type int or integer. And then we're going to print out how many carrots do you have, line return, and then we have this new line here, cin. So from the definition or what cout stands for, I can imagine that you're probably guessing what cin stands for. C output stands for output, and cin stands for input. And then we have it with this kind of familiar little operator here, and then our integer variable that we created early up here, carrots. So this is going to, instead of outputting something to the console like cout does, it's going to do the opposite. It's going to take input from the console, and you can notice that it's taking it from the console and not putting it to the console, which would be confusing because you can't input something to something. You have to get input from something. And you can tell that it's getting it from the console because the little operator here with the greater than sign kind of directs the flow of data or the flow of traffic. So over, you know, on our cout, this string over here is flowing into cout, which is printing it on the screen for us. Here, we are getting input from the console, and it is flowing into our carrots variable. So essentially what this is going to do is it's going to take input from the user on the console, i.e. they'll type some value in, hit enter, and it's going to put whatever they typed in into the variable carrots. Pretty simple. And then we have another line printing out here, two more, and then we are going to add two to carrots. So again, whenever you are defining your or giving your variable a value, it needs to be on the left hand side, and your operation needs to take place on the right hand, or your assignment needs to take place on the right hand. So we're taking carrots, which is whatever the user inputs into the console at this point, and adding two to it. And then we're going to come down here and we're going to print out one more line. Now you have value of carrots after the two has been added to it, and carrots. Then we're going to do an end line. And you might notice that there's no end line up here on this, so actually both of these two cout statements are going to appear on the same line. So it's going to say here are two more, now you have value carrots, and then an end of line. And then we're waiting for an enter key before we move on and return zero. And that's all this program does. Nothing too fancy, but a real quick, easy introduction to the cin command and how to work with input using hashiprush. So, one other thing that I wanted to mention that we talked about in the last episode, kind of, is you can kind of string along various different like strings or values or whatever to one single cout statement. This is called concatenation. In a lot of programming languages, you would have like your concatenation operator would be like a plus sign instead of this operator here. But just with how this command works, since it's actually an object, this object has this specific operator that the code tells when this operator is present, do this certain thing, and what that does with this operator's passes data to that object, and then that object displays runs a function and displays it to the console. Again, mentioning object things, but I'm not going to explain it super in depth right now, so if that's confusing, don't worry. But yeah, basically just reiterating that you can concatenate multiple things to one cout statement, so you don't have to do a separate line for each one. So I don't have to do cout, now you have semicolon, cout carrots, semicolon, new line, cout carrots, cout end line. So saves a lot of space. We already went over that, so I think that's enough of an explanation of that. And now that we have everything in place and explained, let's go ahead and run this. So we'll go ahead and build it, and I'll have to find out a way to, I don't know how I'm going to do it. I'll have to look into it. I've never really done it before, but I'm going to have to find some way to make the text in the console a little bit easier to read, a little bit bigger font. So I'll look into that, see what I can do. But now we have the program running. It's asking how many carrots do we have, so let's just run this cout line, whoops, within the end line at the end. And so right now it's running this line, the cin and carrots, so we're going to enter in a value. Let's go ahead and do, you know, I probably have 4 carrots. That seems like the amount of carrots that I would have if I were to have any. And once we hit enter, it is going to load that value into our variable carrots. Interesting. Alright, let's try that again. 5. Okay. Let's try this. Sorry. Okay. You know? Okay, interesting. I have an inkling of why it is doing that. It's basically because it's already, it's saying, oh, I already have a, actually, let's see. Clear? This might work. If so, that would be great, and I can no, that doesn't do it. All right. Well, I'll have to look into that too now. But for now, we're just going to use a breakpoint. All right, and back to this. So it's waiting for this input. I'm going to put in 4. And once I hit enter here, it's going to put that value into carrots, and then we have our next line, which is displaying here are 2 more, it's adding 2 to carrots, and then it's displaying now you have value of carrots, carrots, end line. So as we see, here are 2 more, now you have 6 carrots. So it did our addition operation here just fine, and that's our program. So I'm going to go ahead and step into and step out. All right. Whoa, super tunnel. Okay, so that's basically all that we have to go over today. Is that the cin command. And that's going to take input, and that's going to allow us to make our programs a little more interactive by, instead of only showing things and telling things to the user, we're going to be able to get input from the user and mess with it and do cool things with it. So that's going to do it for this episode. For the next one, I'm going to go ahead and find out why it's skipping over my get car or my cn.get. So there's one other thing. Another option Let me try this. I don't know if this will run. No. No overload function takes it. Get line. Nope, that's not gonna work either. Okay. I'll have to look into it. But basically, another way to accomplish the same thing that the get car command does is using the same input, we can use this command called cn.get, and that'll wait for a character to be input as well. But for some reason it's not stopping before it returns, so again I'll look into that and have that ready for you in the next episode to explain that. But that's going to do it for today. Today we learned about input a little bit. Tomorrow we're going to go a little more into using functions and just functions in general. Should be a pretty quick explanation of it. But yeah, hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and hit the like button. I definitely appreciate it. And if you want to see more of this, you can always subscribe for free. And get those updates to your subscription box. Then if you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below, and I will be taking a look at them. All right, you guys have a good one.